Hey everyone, Glenn here from Mind Over Meniere's. I wanted to make a video today to try to explain what it's like to live with and be diagnosed with Meniere's disease. I think this is something that a lot of people really struggle with. It's really difficult to explain what it's like to live with Meniere's disease, to explain the struggles and the suffering that a lot of us go through. And it's something that I've thought a lot about over the years. Most people have never even heard of Meniere's disease. It only affects one out of every 500 or so people. And to this day, I've only ever met a small handful of other Meniere's patients in person. So I think that when our family and our friends can't even understand, it's hard for us to expect the rest of society to understand what we're going through. And that's a big hurdle that we're going to have to overcome to raise awareness for this terrible disease. But I'm going to give it a shot and try to explain what it's like. For starters, most people will never know what it's like to face a rare and complicated medical diagnosis. Now, that's not to say they'll never get sick. They may, and they may get really sick. But most of the time, it will at least be easy to comprehend what they're dealing with. Their doctor will be knowledgeable. They'll explain all the different treatment options. And at the very least, they'll have a good idea of what they need to do next. But when you suffer from such a complicated and rare condition like Meniere's disease, there are no certainties. There's very little understanding, and there's a lot of pain and confusion and despair. And unfortunately, hope is just not a part of the equation for a lot of us. And that's a big problem because I really feel like there is hope for everyone. There's always hope. So I want you to close your eyes and think back to a time in your life when everything was going really good. Now imagine you're walking along one day when all of a sudden everything starts to spin around you. Your whole world starts to spin like you're on a tilt-a-whirl. Of course, you fall to the ground and all you can really do is hold on for dear life. You don't know it, but you're experiencing vertigo. It feels like you're very, very drunk, but you haven't had any alcohol. Your brain is suddenly in shock and thinks that you might be poisoned, so you get very nauseous and you start throwing up, but it doesn't help because, of course, you haven't been poisoned. The world just keeps spinning around you. You can't focus your eyes. You might be able to open your eyes, but it's very difficult. You're completely incapacitated as the minutes turn to hours and time just keeps going by. You're terrified. You're confused. You can't get up or walk or do anything. We tend to take our balance for granted, but our equilibrium comes with no guarantees. Your balance is controlled by your vestibular system and your vision system, and both of those systems can become compromised. The hours go by and everything is still spinning, but maybe less intensely now. Your world is slowly resolving back into place. Reality stabilizes, and you can finally open your eyes again. But you have no idea of what just happened. You're left thinking that something is really, really wrong with you. You have no answers. You're filled with questions with no answers. So you go to the doctor. But your doctor doesn't know what's going on either. If you're lucky, you'll end up seeing an ENT or a specialist who may have some experience diagnosing and treating vestibular disorders and balance disorders. But if you're unlucky, you may go for years before you talk to anyone with any kind of idea of what's going on, suffering the entire time without any kind of explanation or understanding. If you do get lucky, your luck might sound something like this. We're going to have to run some tests, but it looks like you have Meniere's disease. There is no cure. They don't know what causes it, and every time you have a vertigo attack, your hearing is going to be damaged permanently, a little bit. Over time, you may lose your hearing entirely. You have to immediately cut out alcohol, coffee, you have to go on a lower sodium diet, you have to lower your stress, you have to get healthy, you have to start exercising, you have to do all of these things, and you have to do them now. It's a lot to take in. So you leave the doctor's office, and you're terrified. You want to understand, but nothing makes sense anymore. The problem just became very real and very permanent. So you go home, and you start searching on Google for Meniere's disease. But everything just gets a whole lot worse because so much of what you find will conflict with everything else you find, and so much of what you find is negative. So very quickly, a picture of the worst case scenario becomes fixed in your mind, and all the while, you're suffering. You're having vertigo attacks, There's a constant feeling of pressure and fullness in your ears that's extremely uncomfortable. Your hearing is impaired, and you're worried about going deaf. And your senses turn against you too. Suddenly, bright lights, crowded areas, and noisy environments will overwhelm you in an instant. And your job is in jeopardy too. That's assuming you even still have a job. Your boss and your coworkers think you're overreacting. And through it all, there's the fear. The fear of having a vertigo attack pervades everything. It can make it hard to leave the house. You constantly fear that it's going to happen again, and you have no idea of when it's going to strike next. And even if you're not having vertigo, you're still cognitively impaired by brain fog, fatigue, dizziness, and you have tinnitus to deal with, and there are no certainties anymore. You look fine, so no one thinks you're sick, but you are. You're really sick, and no one believes your pain. It's really a hard position to be in, and you just don't know what to do next. Now, I know this is a really dark picture that I'm painting here, but it's easy to see why so many people lose hope. But the truth is that it's not entirely bad. A lot of people are able to improve their symptoms with careful lifestyle management, with medication, and in more stubborn cases, various surgeries can help as well. So many people like me do learn to live in harmony with their symptoms and go on to live productive or somewhat productive lives. But it is not an easy journey. And when the people around us, especially the people closest to us, don't understand, it can make everything else so much more difficult. But again, it is possible to succeed, and that possibility is what gives us hope. It's why I started this blog and this YouTube channel and wrote a book to show people that, there is hope. It took me years to find ways to cope and to manage my symptoms, years of trial and error, and I share my stories and I share my ideas because if information is the missing piece, no one should ever have to suffer for years. So if you or if someone you love suffers from Meniere's disease, I encourage you to share this video with them, share your story with them. You can write a blog or make a video to share your story with others. I think the power of your story is enormous, and that together our stories and our voices will be heard, and hopefully we'll be able to raise awareness and bring attention to this terrible condition. So that's all for now. Thanks, everybody. I'll have a lot more of these videos to come in the future.
Crowded hallways are the loneliest places for outcasts and rebels, or anyone who just dares to be different. And you've been trying for so long to find out where your place is, but in their narrow minds there's no room for anyone who dares to do something different. Oh, but listen for a minute. Trust the one who's been where you are, wishing all it was sticks and stones. Those words cut deep, but they don't mean you're all alone. And you're not invisible. Hear me out. There's so much more to life than what you're feeling now. Someday you'll look back on all these days, and all this pain is gonna be invisible. All invisible. So your confidence is quiet. To them, quiet looks like weakness. But you don't have to fight it, 'cause you're strong enough to win without a war. Every heart has a rhythm. Let yours beat out so loudly that everyone can hear it. Yeah, I promise you don't need to hide it. doing something different. It dare to be something more. Just the one who's been where you are, wishing all it was sticks and stones. Yeah, the words come deep, but they don't mean you're all alone. And you're not invisible. Hear me out. There's so much more to this life than what you're feeling now. And someday you'll look back on all these days, and all this pain is gonna be
invisible. It'll be invisible.